This is the Reality Radio Network on Telstar 5 Transponder 5 and on the internet at realityradionetwork.com.
And now, Sherry Talk Radio.
Everybody, and welcome to the show. Tonight, Rick Vizzuti is going to be on the show with me, and we're going to talk about aliens in our midst, hybrids, alien children, shapeshifters, anything and everything that has to do with aliens. And he's going to call in at 9:30, and it's going to be a great show. I've known Rick. I've known him forever, probably about 4 or 5 years now. One of the first guys I knew that had a website on aliens, and in fact, he had his site up long before I had the WatcherFiles.com up, when it was Rick who designed the logo for that site. And most people know me by the logo with the alien above the White House. And so he's going to be on tonight. You know, it's just time. I usually wait for the Lord to just lead me on doing show by shows, week by weeks. And there's been a pattern of the types of shows that I've done, if you look back over them. I mean, for a while, I'll talk about the New World Order, and then I'll talk about the Nocera agenda, and talk about pre-Adamic times, and now lately it seems that, you know, just getting people generally prepared for themselves for what's going on in their own midst, you know, the aliens, the veil's being lifted, and we're being bombarded. Well, we're going to have aliens coming out of our ears soon enough, and so tonight we're going to get some more info out on that and give you plenty of scriptures for you to look at. You know, I'm looking forward tonight. Give me a call for now. I'm going to use this first half hour. It's a time for listener call-ins. If you have a comment or question, 260-356-2611. I've been busy the past week. Finally got the proof sent out to the publisher. Aliens on the Internet will be available in about 2 to 3 weeks, direct through my publisher, and then in about 4 weeks it'll be available at Amazon. And then shortly after that it'll hit the bookstores. But you can always get it on the net first before you can bookstores. So if you have questions or comments that you want to ask, call in the first hour tonight, because while Rick's on the show, I won't be having listener call-ins during that time. Rick is calling in from Canada, and I originally wanted him on the show last Tuesday at Aliens in the News, and we couldn't work that out, and so I'm bringing him in tonight on this show, on this network, and it's going to be a great show. You know, Rick's got a lot of great stuff on his site. You can go preview his site at starguides.org. He also has a book out, Return of the Star Gods, and just a lot of information to chew on. It's been pretty much a quiet week, basically. I know a lot of people going on vacation or not. And one of the things, though, lately that I've been reading about, I'm getting these emails from people, and they're like, I think I'm a target. I'm under surveillance. Weird things are happening to me. People are following me, and they're freaking out. I mean, they're just totally freaking out. And it's like, you know what, people? We're all targets. Anybody who is against the New World Order, anybody who loves the Most High God as Lord, is a target. And so you're going to be harassed and put under surveillance and stuff. And I just, you know, I have no fear with this stuff. And so a lot of you Christians that are just pulling the hair out of your head, you're freaked out, you're shocked, you're surprised, and then you just forget everything about who you are in the Lord, Install your panic. Don't just something to panic about. You know, Satan has been around for thousands of years. He's always targeted us with his demonic entities. And these aliens and the government that works his black agenda are nothing new. I mean, the only thing is now that's becoming more prevalent is they don't stay as hidden as well as they used to. I mean, they don't care if you know. I mean, the veil's being lifted. Lucifer's time to rule and reign on this earth is coming. Planet X is coming closer to the earth every day. We have the dark star. We have all these different anomalies in space coming towards the earth. Practically have Satan's whole solar system heading our way, this mini solar system from Orion. And, of course, we know that's his home seat. And there's one thing that gags me the most, and that's to hear all these prophecies on prophetic boards and stuff, claiming how the Lord's heaven is coming down from Orion, or how the Lord's heaven is based in Orion. And that's not the Most High God. That's not the Lord of the Bible. That's Satan, folks. That's his mimic of heaven. That's his home seat, is the constellation of Orion. And so many of them have become channelers for Lucifer and just don't even realize it. And when you tell them, they just throw a fit. You know, they scream and they hem-haw and they holler and they call you false and call you a liar and call, you know, everything under the sun, because they refuse to acknowledge that they're being deceived, that they're being played, that they're listening to that voice in their head, which is a channeling, and not the still small voice in their spirit, which is the Lord's. I mean, there's a huge difference, folks. And I know some people are just so excited because they're hearing a voice and they want to attribute it to God. And, of course, it sounds religious. You know, you're either quoting scripture or calling them, children or little ones or whatever. They're not exact word for word. I mean, there are things in the way that they say things and how they use phrases and say things that you can tell that they're not the Most High God. You know, and some of these people just never picked up on that. I've never really made it. I know a lot of people have asked me, how do you know? And I'll give them telltale signs how you can tell when a prophecy isn't of the Lord and stuff. But I can't detail it all out in black and white, because the thing is, there are so many aliens on the Internet today that do nothing but go through and copy and database everybody's prophecies and visions, that if I told them everything I know, then they would just turn around and mimic their deceptions even all the more greater, you know. And so what you need to do is you need to seek the Lord to give you discernment on knowing when he is speaking and when he isn't, especially reading other people's material that are attributing the name's Lord's name to it, you know. And that's the big thing, because the more you know who he is, the more you know who he isn't, the more you know how he talks, the more you know how he doesn't. And then you can go to these, and I'm not promoting them, but it's a good way of, if you can handle meat, you know what to chew and what to spit out. You can go to their own source sites, 4winds10.com, nasera.us.com, and look at their news articles and their email articles and their lists and the channelings that they do through these followers. And you can see how they talk to their own followers through these channelings. And then you can turn around and see it coming through our own churches as well, by people who call themselves prophets. You know, and so it's amazing. There's no the similarity that's there. There's no difference. I mean, they're using the same kind of language, the same kind of lingo that the New Age channelers are using from the beings. They'll come out and just call Sananda Emmanuel or Sananda Maitreya or Germain. You know, Sananda is a title. It's the name of Christ. It's another name for Christ. And so they have Sananda Emmanuel, and he's the one that looks like Jesus, exactly like him. And then you have Sananda Maitreya, which is Christ Maitreya, and he's the Arab. He's the darker-skinned one, or not the darker-skinned, but darker-haired. His skin doesn't look very dark, maybe olive color to it. Most of these guys are Aryan-looking. But he's Arab, and he's going to be the big Messiah for the Arabs in the East. And why he and how he becomes so dominant.